I never thought about asking if you wanted to say it.
Well, is that 20 pages?
No.
No, I'm always just, it's written.
So I can look at it without my glasses. So basically, I want to give thanks to Nami, Gail, Dr. Goodlow, Jane, and all the members who have chosen to honor me today with this award. I want to thank those of my family. Can you hear me?
No.
I want to thank those who gotten up early on Saturday to come with me. My son Kevin, who works for the United States Tennis Association and does a lot of work with special needs children. My brother Louis, whom some of you know because he's a great
the best.
Disability benefits. And my right hand person, Don, and my daughter-in-law Olivia, who's taking pictures back there. I've learned from Gail and from working more with patients, loved ones, medical and support staff, court officials, and fellow attorneys, that while there may be different treatment processes for individuals experiencing mental illness, the bumpy road we have to take to reach our goals with seemingly endless delays and painful detours cannot be traveled alone. While we wish the setting where we find ourselves would be less congested, we realize that we all need each other for support. We all play a role. You all play a role in the process. Last week, I was with a patient from Metropolitan State Hospital in Court. His speech was so disconnected and reduced to literal mumbling because of his schizophrenia. Yet when I listened to him outside the courtroom, he made sense to me, and he was able to communicate his wishes to me. I really could see that he had some insight into his condition. Insight, beautiful insight. The best and first sign of hope for improvement for all of our loved ones with mental illness. In the courtroom, when we tried to go through a rehearsal dialogue to show the judge that the conservatee had capacity to waive a jury trial, our rehearsed dialogue did not go off as well as planned, but it was sufficient. And when we left the courtroom, I asked my client if he felt okay about what we were doing because I really wanted to protect his rights. What you have to understand is that an attorney can be appointed to represent a patient as well as a conservator. This client, a young man whose parents are not able to deal with him and are not able, they just can't face seeing him right now, who came from Metropolitan State Hospital, shackled with stiffened joints, saw that I was feeling sad because I did not want to let him down. In spite of his situation, he was the one who gave me a reassuring hug because he wanted me to feel better. I see this every day in court. I have cases now where longtime conservatees who've remained compliant thanks to you, family members, and friends, now are in reverse situations where the conservatees are stepping up to the plate to help disabled parents or loved ones who previously spent so many years of their lives helping them. It's a two-way street. The love we give our loved ones with mental illness often is returned. We all need help at some point in life. I feel very fortunate to have the opportunity to come in contact and learn so much from so many interesting people from all backgrounds. Mental illness is an equal opportunity predator. It forces us to forget petty prejudices, get to work, work together, and learn from each other. I learn and get so much more from having the opportunity and privilege to work with each and every one of you, more than I ever could give back to you. I want to thank you all for this award, which really should go to you. Gail's motto, treatment prevents stigma. We all shall continue to work to get the best treatment for our loved ones, and we all shall continue to combat the social stigma that accompanies mental illness. In addition to medical treatment and intervention, the way we all treat each other as human beings makes such a big difference. While stigma in society must be addressed, I prefer to think of the stigma of the flower as a symbolic receptacle of the love, dedication, and fight which constitute the collaborative effort all of you put into cultivating more and more ways of conquering the challenges of mental illness. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Your last name.
I'm going to email you that video.